Hey everyone, in this video I'm going to do something that I haven't done in a while but I love doing, and that is leveling up a design. So it's this design right here. It's from a fellow follower, and I just want to show him and everyone how you may level up this design. So I'm going to use one of the basic layouts, this one right here, number 3. You could use 1, 2, or 3. In fact, you could use any one of them, but I don't have the time to go through all of them. I'm going to show you how to do it just following it here. So there's lots of different ways you could level up this one, but I'm going to show you some basic layouts that you can do. And I'm going to use Canva for free because I believe this person used Canva for his design. And I'm going to show you how to download it and how to do some research on TeePublic, because this design was found on TeePublic and he's trying to get some sales on there. So I'm going to show you everything I know on how to make this better and how to give yourself a better chance of getting a sale on TeePublic with these designs. So let's go to TeePublic first, and I'll show you some research that I would do before even designing. All right, so here we are on TeePublic, teepublic.com. And you know, this site has some really cool designs right here. So I'm just scrolling down to show you some of the ideas that you could see. Like, illustration and design is really important here, right? Like, you can see these all look like they're designed by artists. So that's one thing you need to take in mind. Next thing you can do, if you did your research and found a topic, let's see, the thing that was on the t-shirt was, "In pizza, we crust," I believe that's what it said. And you can see the search results are showing, I'm guessing this is, I don't know if this is newest or popular, I'm guessing this is trending, because if you click newest and popular, they're going to be different. But let's look at this for now. You notice this eye thing is a repetitive theme. So you may want to go that way if you want to do that. There's also these banners, things like that. This one's really different. I like that. That one's really cool. Some nice artist stuff. This one was probably done by AI, because pizza has 3 Z's here and crust is kind of weird here. But I don't know. I guess it's selling. I don't know. Pizza, we crust. If we go all the way down, we notice that this topic has 6 pages worth of "In Pizza We Crust," and I'm gonna see newest. So yeah, that wasn't newest. You can see more and more people are adding to this, and popular. So that wasn't popular too. I think the first result was trending, and you'll see again a lot of these themes here with the eye there and some banners and things like that. So you can go 2 ways on this. You can try and compete with having that eye, because we know that's popular on here. Or you could go the opposite way, you know, and everybody zigs, you zag, and do something totally different. And that's what I'm going to do, is go totally different. But you may also think, well, 6 pages of competition, can we do something else with pizza? I mean, competition is great. It means that people are looking for this and most likely buying this. So, I mean, that is a good thing. But if we just did funny pizza, let's try this. Funny pizza, and we scroll down, we'll notice there's 50 pages. So of course, funny pizza is way too big. But if we did popular, just one idea now, we got the tarot card pizza. That's kind of cool. We got this. So we got different ideas to do pizza stuff. And if we want to go and look around and trying to see, like, let's just take this one right here, legalize marinara. I'm just gonna type it in here just to show you the difference. Legalize, hopefully it's different, marinara. So it pulls up here, which is a good sign. So here we are on legalize marinara, and I just wanted to show you, if we scroll all the way down, only 1 page, so a lot less competition. So do your research. It doesn't mean that you're gonna get sales on this one, but it definitely means there's less competition. And if this is popular and it is something people are looking for, you have a better chance, assuming that you have something good to sell on here, to get a sale. But I'm not gonna do a design for this. I'm gonna do the design for the other one, just using the same phrase, even though it may be harder to get sales with that one. So let's get into Canva, and I'll show you exactly what I would do to kind of stand out, be different, and That's the approach I'm going to do, is try and do something totally different, not use the Illuminati eye or whatever it's called, and not use the banners and things like that. I'm going to try and stand out and use that design that I showed you, that layout that's super simple. All right, so here we are on Canva. I'm going to use Canva free, even though I have a pro account. I'm going to try and use some of the free things that are on there. I'm going to hit create design first. And we can do a t-shirt right here. It's 14 by 18, but I'm gonna do custom just to make sure. I'm not exactly sure if that's 4,500 by 5,400. I don't think it is 14 by 15. I think 14 by 18. I think 15 by 18 is what we want in inches converted to pixels. So I'm just gonna do custom size. I already have it here, 4,500 by 5,400 pixels. I'm gonna click on that. You could have typed that in. You can see it's about the same size. So the first thing we're gonna do is look for pizza. You can see I've researched that before, but let's do this again. Pizza, I'm gonna say see all in graphics. I'm gonna do free, just so we keep it there. And let's see what we got. Why not use this guy? This guy is different, it's very retro. I didn't see a lot of this kind of art in there. So one way to stand out is to use a kind of different art. We saw a lot of the different pizzas, but we didn't see, you know, things like this where he's pointing or he's walking, or even a cat pizza that would have stood out too. So we can use any of those. I'm just gonna use this guy right here, just really quick. All right, make him big here. Now he's not filling that space, and in that layout we want to kind of fill that space in here. And one way you can do that really easily is with shapes. So I'm going to clear this off here. You can see there's shapes right there. I'm going to just pick that rectangle. And the nice thing about this is that it doesn't have to be a square. It can be a rectangle. And I'm going to just put it in the back here as a spot. Now I could put the whole thing back here, but what I like to do is try to have more colors. So with more colors, I'm going to just eyeball it like that. I can move my position here to all the way in the back, so it's behind, and I can hold down option and shift and click and drag and just put it there. Now I believe is that's a thing I used before. I'm just going to use option click drag again, so we can do that and that and that. And I think that might be too tall. Let's go back and make these smaller. Can I just do the whole thing? Yes, I can. So right there and there. There you go. So I have five. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Now if it's not tidy up, if it's not straight and stuff, you can hit tidy up here, or vertical alignment, or tidy up. It's already done. So that you can see the spacing behind each of these is good. Let me show you what if it wasn't. So let's say you had it all wonky like this. Whoops. Well, maybe that's not a good one. Yeah, there you see. The spacing's all wrong, right? I'm going to hit tidy up. Actually, you want to tidy up when this top one is where you want it to be. There you go. Okay, so space still wonky in between these. You come in here, hit position, and hit either tidy up or vertical. What we really want is vertical. If it was wonky the other way, it would need to be tidied up. Let's see that. Okay, see that is stretching there and there. Okay, now we'll tidy up and see what happens. This tidy up thing is pretty cool. I think I clicked that guy by mistake. Okay, tidy up. Boom. Spacing good, aligned right, so that can really help you if you're not eyeballing it right. Next thing for color, what I'm gonna do is, since there's color in this graphic right here, I'm just gonna add those same colors. So I'm gonna come in here and change the color. I'm gonna use the eyedropper tool right here, and I'm usually gonna start with the lightest color first, the lightest color being white, but because we're on a white background, I'm not gonna do that. So I'm gonna just pick this color here, and then use the eyedropper and pick that other, the dot here. That seems interesting. I can come in here and pick the yellow, I believe is the next brightest color. And then this pepperoni has two colors in it. I got that one. And I'm gonna eyedrop on the darker one in here. Boom. So just like that, super simple. And then the next thing I'm gonna do is type. So we come in here, where's our type text? There it is, add heading, boom. Now, since this is a vintage kind of illustration graphic, I'm gonna look for a vintage font. So I'm gonna come in here, I'm just gonna type in vintage. Look for one that doesn't have the crown, since we're trying to do free stuff. So let's see, this one, Bugaki. That's kind of vintage looking. That's really cool. I'm gonna say in, whoops, gotta type that right. I wanna upper lower, let's see what it looks like. In pizza, I don't know, I kinda like just uppercase. We can play around with it by doing this right here, in pizza. And then stretch it so that it goes edge to edge. That's kind of what we want to do in that layout that we saw. And actually, we're going to have to move everything down except for that. So let's move it down like that in pizza. And I'm going to hold down Option Shift Drag, just like we did with the rectangle. We're going to do with the letters here, we crust. And that's a little bigger, so we're going to have to come down, stretch this out, and like that. Now that was super simple. I would say put this, we can do this on a white shirt or a black shirt. Let me show you what it would look like on a black. I'm going to duplicate this page. I'm going to change this background to black. Now of course the black text doesn't stand out, so that's going to have to be white. We're going to change that to white here. And I think that does really well in white, or black. The text does well in white. We could kind of change it to this right here to match that color, but I don't think so. I think white is good because we have the white gloves and every color is represented there. And there is a really simple design, didn't take too long. And this actually follows that basic layout. So instead of what we had before where everything was kind of put all over the place, this actually looks like a t-shirt design. I think it will give you a better chance of getting a sale. One more thing I think you can do to kind of make this stand out too is I'm gonna go back to elements and I'm gonna add some stars on here just to give it a little bit more interest. So we have big and we want small, right? We have big graphic, we want some small graphics around it that kind of make it interesting. So we could do shapes or we could just do graphics. I'm gonna do graphics here and I'm looking for just one star here like that. And we're gonna size it. And this works really well because there's a lot of roundness to this and this star has roundness. And instead of black, we're gonna use white here so we can do that. And we're just gonna hold down Option and drag and we can put it anywhere we want. So if we want it here and here, maybe make some smaller again to have interest, maybe make this bigger here and so on. I think this could work. And I'm just putting it wherever we want, but yeah, just to add some interest here. I wanna kind of put it on one of each of the levels here. So it doesn't have to be exactly on the level, but it's touching that one's touching, and so on. So we got at least one on each of these to kind of get some interest here. So I like putting these stars where it's rounded, and you can see it's kind of rounded there. It's kind of rounded here, see that? It's kind of rounded here, but not exactly, and here on the hand. So I think that helps, you know, give some interest. So there you go, some rounded stars to add more to the vintage layout. You could put it anywhere you want. And you could change these colors too. So if you want a more of a rainbow color, if you want more of a vintage sunset, maybe you want to add a different color that's not here. Maybe you want to add a green or a blue. Perfectly fine. I just used the colors that were there. I think sometimes we think too hard about what colors to use, and we already have a color palette, right, in the graphic. So I would go to that first if you're not knowing what colors match each other. At least these colors match because we picked it right from the graphic. All right, there you go. You could do some other things to make it stand out, like we could put an outline here, or you can make one of the fonts different, like maybe crust is different or pizza is different. We could look in here and see like pizza text. Maybe there's something. Yeah, so maybe we could do in pizza, you know, we crust instead of this. Let me show you. I mean, maybe that could work to make it stand out. I'm doing Command Z and taking that back. Is there another pizza? That's another pizza. So we could use some of these pizza words right here to kind of help us stand out. So that's another way to do it. So let's take a look. This is the final one right here. This compared to the t-shirt, you can see this stands out not only on a black t-shirt, it's different than the other ones. And that's kind of what you want to do is look at the competition. At least that's what I like to do. Look at the competition, see a way that nobody else is doing, try and find some way to stand out and hopefully get some sales that way instead of trying to make the same thing everybody's doing. And that way you're gonna just get pushed down, right, to page two or three. So next thing you wanna do is kinda hit share and hit download. And if you have the free version, you don't have transparent background, which is why I upgraded to Pro, because if you don't have that, let me show you what you would have to do. You have to hit download here. And now that I have that downloaded, I'm gonna go to Photopea online. And wow, I didn't know this was their new webpage. Pretty cool. I might have to do another tutorial here. I'm gonna drag in that one we did on the black background, dragging it in here. So there it is. And we can just select all the black here. And it's selecting every black part, so that might be a tough one to do, but let's see what happens when we delete that. We'd have to delete this and this and maybe that right there. Oh, that's interesting. So let's see what happens when we do a background. Let's see what happens when we change the background. So I'm gonna move this here. And then add a layer, and let's fill this layer with black first. So I'm gonna do this shape back here like this, and then put this in the back. Yeah, that looks like it works. Let's see what happens if this shape's a different color. So let's try like a red. That could work. And blue. So that's one way to do it. Definitely works best on black or any of the dark shirts colors, because that black got knocked out here with it. So another reason to get Pro on here. You could come in here, because the black touched this black, you would have to kind of go in and not do that part. And you could come in here manually with like your erase tool and kind of do this part of it. But yeah, that's how it would work here. Again, black like that. And then you would download this without the background. So like this. And you'd come in here, file, export as PNG, and then it would export that, what we said, 4500 by 5400, and you would save it. And that's how you would do it. That's how I would do it from here, and then upload that to TeePublic and put it on different things, make sure that it's in black, and have all your tags ready. But very simple design. Again, if you had Pro, or if you draw better, I think that could help you stand out even more. But if you're limited and you're just starting out, I think this is something super simple that anybody could do just with Canva and just with a few things. Like if we didn't make anything very hard, I'm using simple shapes, simple text, simple graphics here. Nothing that anybody couldn't do. Everybody can do this design right here. And I think it looks a lot better. At least it looks more like a t-shirt than the other one. So there you go, that's my level up design for In Pizza We Crust. Now again, you don't have to use the same phrases that you started with, because I would definitely do some research and figure out if it's too saturated or if that's something you wanna do, just to give yourself a better chance of getting more sales. Now, if you wanna see another Canva video that I did recently, I'll put that right here. Let me know in the comments if you love Canva videos or if you wanna see other videos from other applications. I'd love to help you with that as well. Thanks again for watching. And as always, guys, keep creating and keep learning. I'll see you on the next one. Bye.